that gives us no excuse. The enemy is fighting you. Just tell him to prepare to lose. Cause I'm more than a conqueror. I'm more than a conqueror. No matter what you take from me, God still gets glory from me. The kingdom suffering violence, and the violent taking my voice. So today we make a stand, cause we're not
into your court with praise, oh God. Hallelujah. Come to bless your name. And we thank you for your anointing that's upon each and every one of us, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, that as you're pouring out your spirit like never before, our ears are open to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is speaking today. Father, our heart is open to receive what the Spirit of the Lord is speaking today. And Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God, that every blockage is removed, oh God. Everything that will try to frustrate the flow of the Holy Spirit, we cause it to cease now in the mighty name of Jesus. But we thank you, oh God, that you're moving swiftly, oh God. We give you glory, honor, and praise, oh Lord. Hallelujah. You're restoring joy like never before. You're restoring their youth, oh God, like never before. We bind every sickness, oh God, that will try to hinder what you're doing tonight. Oh, how we worship you and thank you, oh God. Have your way in this holy, have your way in this place, Holy Spirit. We don't want to have service without you. We reverence you. We bow down before you. We decrease that the Spirit of the Lord may increase today in the mighty name of Jesus. Have your way, oh God. We come before you like children, oh God, with faith in you, oh God. Hallelujah. Our trust and our hope is in you like never before. Have your way in this place. This is your house, oh God, and we come into your house to worship you, and we remember how great you are in the mighty name of Jesus, and we give you all honor, glory, and praise.
Praise the Lord. I'm just feeling impressed that God is wanting us to increase our trust in him, and things that we would, you know, depend on ourselves for in the times past, he wants us to start to trust him in even greater and deeper ways, for real, for us to lean and depend on him in every way possible. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. This is from the other prophetic voices. Said, what the devil meant for evil, God is turning around for good. God said that he is strengthening this governing body. The Spirit of the Lord says that he's restoring courage to this house, saith God. God says this is your time of war, and you have had challenges, but God says the battle is not yours. God says he has built character in you. So now God says, begin to rejoice, for your help is here. And I hear the Spirit of God says that he is sharpening your vision, saith God. He is sharpening and opening up your eyes. God says, get ready, because the doors are already open, and he's about to show you where your door is in this season. God says, get ready, because the things even that you have written down on paper, God says, I am blowing on them. God says, I'm bringing life to them. God says, get ready for the new life that I am bringing even into your households and even into your finances. God says, in 2011, there's going to be a year of magnitude. God says, the extraordinary is going to be ordinary to you, saith God.
Hallelujah. We serve a worthy God, and he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and bless the Lord in this place. Hallelujah. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Lord, you're worthy, and we give you praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless your name. Hallelujah. Come on, put those hands together. We bless your name tonight, oh God, because you're worthy. And we give you the praise. You're faithful. You're awesome. And we call you Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, you're worthy.
Lord, you're worthy.
And we give you.
Lord, you're worthy.
And we give you.
Always making a way.
And we
give you.
Lord, you're worthy.
And we give you.
Lord, you're faithful.
And we give you.
Lord, you're faithful.
And we give you.
Always making.
And we give you.
Lord, you're faithful.
And we give you.
Hallelujah. Come on and give him praise in this place. He's worthy of the glory. He's worthy of the honor. He's worthy of high praise. Hallelujah. We bless your name.
Lord, you're holy.
And we give you.
And we give you.
Yes, you're holy.
Lord,
and we give you.
And we give you.
Always.
And we
give you the praise.
Lord, you're holy.
And we give you.
Say it again.
Lord, you're holy.
And we give you.
Lord, you're holy.
And we give you.
Always make it away.
And we.
Lord, you're holy.
And we give you.
Come on and give him some praise in this place. He's worthy of the glory. Hallelujah. We serve a worthy God. We serve a faithful God and a holy God. Hey, yet you're awesome.
And we give you.
Lord, you're awesome.
And we give you.
Always making a way.
And we
give you.
Yes,
Lord, you're awesome.
Lord, you're awesome.
And we give you.
And
you're awesome.
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 And we.
And we give you.
Yes, you're awesome.
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 And we. Yes, you're worthy.
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 And we.
And we give you the praise.
Yes, you're worthy.
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 And we.
And we give you the praise.
Name is Jesus.
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 And we.
And we give
you
the praise.
You are Jesus.
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 And we.
And we give you the praise.
Lord, you're faithful.
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 And we.
Yes, you're faithful.
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 And we.
And we give you the praise.
Lord, you're faithful.
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 And you're holy.
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 Holy,
Jesus,
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 Jesus.
Come on and bless him in this way. He's worthy. His name is Jesus. And we glorify him in this way. We magnify him in this way. Come on, say Jesus.
Jesus,
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 Lord, you're worthy,
Lord, you're worthy,
and we give you the praise,
and we give you the praise.
Come on and bless him in this way. Come on and give him the praise. We bless your name, Jesus. We honor your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, because you are holy. Oh, so holy. And we bless your name. Come on and bless him in this place. Oh, there's nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you, Lord, oh no. You are holy. You are holy. Oh, oh, so holy. You are holy. You are holy. Oh, so holy. What a privilege, what a privilege and an honor to worship at your throne, to be called into your presence as your own. Say it again, you are holy, you are holy. Oh, so you are holy, holy Lord. What a privilege and an honor. Oh, to be called. Hallelujah. You are worthy. Oh, so worthy. You are worthy. Yes, you are so worthy. What a privilege and an honor. Oh, to worship. To be called, hallelujah, as your own. Say it again, you are worthy. Oh,
so worthy.
You are worthy. Oh, what a privilege. And an honor, oh, to be called your presence as your own. You are faithful, oh, you are faithful. Yes, you are. What a privilege and an honor to be called your presence and your own. Say that again. You are faithful, God. Yes, you are. You are faithful. Yeah. What a privilege and an honor to be called as your own. Oh, your own, to be called your own. Oh, I can search the heavens high, I can search the earth below, but there's no one. There is no one, no one. I can search the oh, I can search the earth below my. Nobody, nobody, can search heaven's high. I can search earth below. No one. Yes, say it again. I can search. Yes, I can search the earth below, but there's nobody. No one so holy. No one so worthy. No one so faithful. There is. Say it again. There's no one so holy. No one so worthy. No one so faithful. There is. Yeah. Say no one so holy. No one so worthy. No one so faithful. Come on and bless him. There's nobody like him in all the earth. God, we bless your name. Oh, we honor you, Jesus. There is nobody like you in all the earth. Nobody, nobody, nobody. Yeah. Say no one, no one so holy.
No one so holy.
No one so worthy. No one so faithful.
No one so
very, very. No one so holy.
No one so worthy.
No one so faithful. There is no, no one. No one. No one. No one, no one, no one, no one, no one, no one, no, nobody, no one, nobody like you, Lord, nobody like you, Lord. I have searched all over in somebody, but there is nobody, nobody, Lord, nobody like you, Lord. Oh, no one, no one. There is no one, no one. Hallelujah. There is nobody like him in all the earth. And we bless his name. And we honor him and we praise him. Hallelujah. And at this time, we're going to sing our fellowship song. Grab the hand of your neighbor that's standing to the left and to the right of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody say, bless, 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 bless. Say hi, bless, say you're blessed. Say hi, blessed, say you're blessed. Say everybody's blessed. It's my new season. It's my new day. Fresh. It's flowing. Season of power. Prosperity. It's mine. It's already on me. Turn around and greet your neighbor and welcome them back into the house of the Lord.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Let's move together. I'm living in the overflow. I'm living in the overflow. Say,
I'm living in the overflow. I'm living in the overflow.
Yes, I'm living. Yes, I'm living. I've got more than enough. The devil can't take my stuff. Come on. The devil. I've got more than enough. The devil can't take my stuff. I've got more than enough. It's my. It's my new season. It's my new day. Fresh. It's flowing. Season of power, prosperity. It's mine. It's already on me. Hallelujah. 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 How many of you? Hallelujah. How many of you want him to fall on you? Hallelujah.
Come on, let's just continue to worship him. Hallelujah. I just believe what Elder Redwood said. There's an expectancy in this house. Hallelujah. How many of y'all believe that? Come on. There's an expectancy. There's a victory that God is manifesting in this place. Hallelujah. And therefore, can we just worship him tonight? Can we just worship him in the beauty of his holiness? And let's ask him to fall on us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, we ask you to fall on us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and just clap your hands. Amen. Come on. It's a beautiful thing. Amen. Hallelujah. And now let's receive our elder. Hallelujah. Are we receiving our elder? Okay, let's receive our elder. Elder Redwood.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. What I want you to do now is pass out the papers that we're going to read this week. Did you all bring your paper back from last week? And now we will stand.
Come on, give God a praise offering. Amen. You got your papers? Everybody got their papers? Okay, have a seat, and we're going to get you your papers. Me and Kinko's gonna have a fight. They just mess with me. Okay. We're gonna go over the 21st and the today's. All right, while we're doing that, Apostle Turner called me earlier, and God had given him a word between last night and early in the morning for the churches in our network. And he said, the word of the Lord, dated December 28th, 2010, the armies of heaven and the earth must prepare for battle. He said he heard the sound like a clang, clang, and shouts. And he said that the Lord told him that the people must consecrate themselves for a great move of God, for miracles, healings, and restoration shall break out among you, of which you have not seen nor experienced or known. My presence shall manifest among my people like never before to do mighty exploits. I am restoring the house. I'm restoring the vision that the enemy thought he destroyed years ago. Many have walked away, said Liberty Temple and Apostle Turner will never rise again. He said, but by my mighty hand, I delivered Egypt out of the house of Israel, out of the house of bondage. By my mighty hand, I shall bring and restore liberty and you who walk with my servant and this vision. The angelic hosts have been assigned to walk up and down in the sanctuary, inspecting and cleaning areas with brooms in the spirit, even near the baptismal area. He said, victory and judgment shall perpetuate throughout the new year. Prepare yourselves with prayer and worship. Come before my throne with singing and worship that the house has never known. I shall restore this vision. I shall restore those who have been faithful, said the Lord. And then he got in his spirit Psalms 126. And it says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongue with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord have done great things for them. The Lord have done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 It's a good word of the Lord. Amen. Thank the Lord for restoration. How many people believing for restoration? Amen. How many people believing for restoration? Hallelujah. Amen. God is going to do some marvelous things. Amen. In our last lesson, we're going to go kind of swiftly for you. I talked about the place of penetration in the life of believers in spiritual warfare when the enemy tries to come in and attack. It's either through the body, the soul, or the mind and the spirit. And after we've been born again, that's what Paul said, the first thing that we need to do is to renew our minds. And Romans 6 and 13 says our bodies must be offered as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable to God, which is your reasonable spiritual service. And one of the things, as we were talking the beginning of this year, the Lord had given us for the beginning of the year that, you know, people taking first fruit offerings, but the life of the believer is your first fruit offering. Amen. Because long before God accepts our sacrifices, our offerings, our vows, our gifts, he wants our lives. Amen. Because, I mean, if we're not vessels of honor or holy vessels, then what good is our money? Come on, somebody. Come on, amen. That's what the word says. And so we have to be be cognizant of our lifestyle, of what we're really about. Amen. We're going to talk about that next lesson. So David said, create in me or shape fashioned by cutting, cut down, cut out, transform in the likeness and the image of God. Clean, meaning make us morally, ethically, physically whole, renew and rebuild and repair us. Amen. How many people came to the Lord broken? Amen. And give us a right heart, a right spirit. Make us faithful and prosperous and stable. Amen. Established and enduring heart. Amen. And a breath, his breath, a prophetic spirit, a courage and a renewed mind. And we talk about that the thief comes to steal, to kill, or the oppression of Satan and his demons is to attack each of these areas so that we will break down. Amen. And so he utilizes or comes to attack our bodies, not just through sickness, but through our appetites, through lust, through clothes, sex addictions, pornography, shopping, overeating. Amen. Because why? We don't have any balance, any discipline in our lives through cancer and arthritis, epilepsy, asthma, any incurable disease, through sleeplessness. How many people know that your body heals itself while you're sleeping? Amen. That you must get rest through lethargy and pain, nervousness, and through the soul tormenting, through thoughts of accusations and temptations, through distractions and terror and insanity, through blocked memory. Anybody ever had blocked memory where you just couldn't remember anything? Come on, amen. It puts like a shadow over your memory. Amen. And cause you to forget or not remember at all and make your mind sluggish. Or either we go the other way and have compulsive thoughts or block our understanding so that we cannot grasp hold of the word of God. Is anybody with me? I'm by myself. All right. Amen. And he also will take our soul, our will, because it's in our control. Our will, God does not touch our will. We give God our will. Amen. But he'll make us weak so that we won't have the will to follow through. We become passive. Amen. Or either attack us in our emotions. Amen. We either fearful, got full anxiety, anger, rage, shame, rejection, grief, you know, and so everything is out of proportion. Everything is out of proportion. And you can't hear the gospel when all your life is out of proportion. Come on, amen. And then we have so many people going one way. We want to concentrate on things other than being saved and keeping ourselves so that when the end time comes, we are fit for the kingdom. Amen. I was sharing with one of the brothers, you know, we can talk about end time. We can talk about 666. We can talk about what's happening in America. We could talk about the dollar bill. We can talk about the Federation. We can talk about all these things. But nevertheless, if you're talking about them and you're not preparing for them. The Bible said, forsake not the assembly of ourselves together. The Bible said, how can we hear without a preacher? The Bible says, without faith, it's impossible to please God. Come on, somebody. Amen. So we can do all these things, but we must align our lives with the word of God. And we must be clean vessels, new creations. Anybody? Amen. So we got to deal with some issues. How many people know that most of the church got issues? Oh, y'all, come on. Amen. Most of the church got issues. We got head issues. We got envying issues. We got jealousy issues. We got gossiping issues. Come on, somebody. Amen. Got lust issues. We don't know if we want to be a man. We want to be a woman. We want to be married to a woman. We a woman, man. We don't know. In the church, we got issues, and people must be delivered to be prepared for the coming of the Lord. So while we need knowledge, we also need cleaning. We also need deliverance. Amen. And you cannot get delivered. See, you know, people have been coming and getting deliverance, and we've been not really understanding the magnitude of what we have grown with. Enemies of our soul, from our youth, from our mother's wombs. All y'all won't have me. Amen. Rejections and ancestral, generational curses, and we haven't understood how to discern so that we can properly cast out demons. Come on, amen. And understand the root of their activities. And so because we speak deliverance in generalities, a lot of people have not really been fully delivered. Am I teaching? Amen. And now God is giving us, you know, to bring clarity to the spirit world so that we're not afraid of the spirit world. We're not afraid to call a devil a devil. We're not afraid to say, I need to be delivered from this thing. Amen. Because it isn't about your neighbor, it's about you. And you're here because you want understanding for yourself so that you can walk upright before God, so that you can come clean. And guess what? A lot of things, we are responsible for the sin that's in our children's lives. Y'all. But we don't want to take that responsibility. We want to say, we taught you right. And we remove ourselves from and give ourselves the okay for our sin. And we sin in front of our children. Y'all hear what I'm saying? Amen. And then when they take on the nature, or when the enemy comes in our house and they start dealing in the things that you used to do, you want to beat them down. But you open the door. The parent opened the door. Come on, somebody. Amen. When babies, I'm feeling this in the home. When babies are allowed to sleep in their parents' room, and then if they tampered with and they start humping, don't you know a spirit have entered them? That lust has entered them. Perversion has entered them. Because the baby don't belong in the parents' room. in the bed with the parent. Amen. And at some point, you know, breastfeeding is wonderful, but when they start getting teeth, That's kind of. Amen. We do all kind of things not thinking when we allow fathers to start taking our daughters when they're like 5 and 6 and they're learning their private parts. And he's still wiping her. That's not good. That's not good. Pass the diaper. He shouldn't be going to the bathroom with the baby girl or the baby boy. Well, the baby boy, you know, he got to teach him. You know what I'm saying? Amen. So we're coming to the point in grace where we are cooperating with the spirit of knowledge. The Bible said we perish because of lack of knowledge. Amen. I got the scriptures for us. And so then he attacks our spirit through unbelief or spiritual lethargy. We can say that this is the most advanced of centuries in the realm of technology and all of that, but this is the most laziest generation in the spirit world. Don't want to come to church, don't want to read our Bible, but we want to tap into revelations. Amen. So we must close the doors, not the door. We have doors in our lives, in our houses, that must be closed. Bible say when you find the right way, walk in it. Amen. And so we must remind Satan that it is imperative for us to remind Satan of what the scripture says and who Jesus is, because we know that the devil and his demons hate the word of God. And when we consistently read and meditate, it will weaken his ability to war against our spirit. Amen. So the very part that's to love God is subject to its weaknesses because it is handicapped and undernourished. If our hearts are handicapped and undernourished, our soul, our mind, our emotions are handicapped and undernourished because how we get our sustenance is through the word of God. If you read the Beatitudes, Jesus is telling us how to keep our sustenance, keep our strength. So he has to understand that our protection, we see the devil said, I can't mess with Job because you still got a hedge around him. And so I saw in one of my references, I saw this diagram that they have drawn around the body, soul, and spirit. It was like a wave around, which was representing like a hedge. And then it showed how as long as the person, us, the believer, was walking with God, was in that word, doing everything they know to be saved, that when those fiery darts come, they would bounce off of them, could not penetrate the hedge Ooh, hallelujah. Amen. But if he gets into our body, our soul, our will, that's how he just gets into our lives. Amen. So Ezekiel 22 and 30 said, I searched for a man among them who would build up the wall and stand in the gap before me for the land so that I would not destroy, but I found no one. Amen. He found no one that will stand in the gap. Amen. So what does that mean? I found no one to have contact with in the earth to strengthen the hedge. Huh? I found no one, because we praying as it is in heaven, let it be in the earth. He said, but for the strength of the earth or the land, I have to have those in the earth that are godly. Come on, to stay in contact with me, to strengthen and protect the head. Is that good? Amen. So the house must be guarded. It must be kept clean. We got to guard our spirits against unforgiveness. And forgiveness is setting of our will and making a decision, making a decree at that spiritual level that a release is granted to the offending person or situation or organization. Stop ceasing to feel resentment against those who have offended us. Amen. It's a necessary and on purpose action. Amen. It's biblical. It's necessary. The Bible said if you don't forgive, God won't forgive you. How many people be in church unforgiving? That's deep right there. Amen. And shout. And speaking in tongues. Amen. Now, years ago, we used to be like, nah, them false tongues. But we wouldn't know a false tongue. Y'all, come on. Amen. We don't know false tongues. But the Bible says you'll know them by their fruit. Amen. Then we have to forgive ourselves. We're going to revisit that. And you have to choose to forgive yourself. You have to choose to release yourself from every accusation, every judgment, hatred, slander, mistake, and even falling short of the mark. Because the righteous man falls 7 times. Amen. But if you don't ask for forgiveness, baby, you dust yourself off and you start all over. Amen. Amen. So forgiveness is a heart issue. Amen. But unforgiveness is a doorstop for the enemy. Amen. So you can read these scriptures. Amen. And then lastly, we don't want to let him in. Amen. Because once he gets in, he's in. And he just stayed. You know, I shared with you how when the Bible said in sin, my mother, come on, did conceive me. And so we know that literally, at the door of the womb, sin comes and attaches itself to that child. So we have to pray, and when he gains entrance, he just don't fight fair. The first thing he gonna attack is your emotions and your mind. Amen. So they're high. You must stay prayerful. You must be ready to repent. Re-meditating your word day and night. Then you will make your way prosperous. Then you'll have what? Amen. Demon's greatest work is through bitterness, jealousy, selfishness, ambition, arrogance, lying, cursing, anger, and deception. Amen. Amen. It is so much. Literally, we could be learning a whole year and still not have it all. Our objective is to strengthen your prayer life. Knowledge strengthens your prayer life, because then you'll know how to pray, and you'll know what to pray, and you'll use the scriptures more effectively to fight demon spirits. Amen. So then when we get knowledge and get understanding, then you really breaking down hedges, you breaking down walls. Come on, somebody. Amen. I'm telling you, this prayer for this year has been so effective. Amen. We've been dealing with situations with Internal Revenue. Today they sent us a refund. Now that's a miracle. They didn't keep it and say we putting it on the old stuff. They sent us a refund. That's a breakthrough right there. Because God said that was going to happen. But if you don't know how to effectively come against the oppressor, then you're going to have some issues and some problems. And in believing your own prayers work. You got to believe that your prayers are effective. And that, you know what, devil, you going to bow down. You going to bow down, amen, however you got to bow down. If an angel have to come cut your legs off, you going to bow down. Amen. Whatever your faith says, it will be. Amen. You just going to have to, you know, take courage and know that you got to go through some things. Amen. And not exaggerate. Amen. That God is a deliverer, and he is going to deliver. Bible saying when you've done all you know to do, just keep standing and thanking him. Amen. All right, we're going to the 28th. We're going to get through this, I promise. This is not going to take me long. The 28th, they just passed it out, sweetie. Who got the 28th? Can y'all share? Could somebody share? It's more people coming to church. Y'all, you know, it is. It's more people coming to church. Where y'all been? Amen. Can we look on with somebody, please? Well, somebody pass somebody on that row some. Well, just listen, and then I'll get you some. I'll do some more copies. Okay, if y'all keep coming, then y'all going to have to copy this. All right, so we're going to go to the lesson, and I promise I'll bring more copies with me next week. Amen. Amen. I talk about that, how that we have been in a very extensive learning process here, and but we it's a necessary process, because as I'm asking God, God is showing me our progression in the realm of the spirit. I could just see the growth. I can see, you know, that it was the wisdom of God that would even give me this kind of format to give you the notes and, you know, let you really see it all yourself, rather than just expecting you to take notes from it, unless, you know, you can put notes on. But we everything that occurs in our lives that we deem wrong is not always a demon, even though we want to believe Satan did it. But at some point, we must take responsibility for our emotions, our wills, amen, and our hearts. Amen. And we must say, what did I do? Have you ever said, what did you do? See, that's humility. Humility is not going to think of itself more higher than it ought to think. Amen. If something goes wrong, I'm going to say, you know what? Maybe I did something. Lord, reveal it to me. But in Luke 22, in the KJV, Jesus to Peter, he says, but I have prayed for thee that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, when you turn around, amen, you know how close you are to God. Now, you might pretend you all let up in here. Hey, come on, somebody. Amen. But you know for real how close you are to God. And so what the Bible is teaching us, he says, then when you get a turnaround, then you go and strengthen your brother. You can't win your brother till you win yourself. Oh, y'all won't have me. You got to heal yourself before you can get somebody, because you can't see through the clouds. Come on, of your mind, that's over your mind, the webs and all the things that are blocking you. Amen. And Paul says it like this. He says, 1 Corinthians 9, he said, but like in the Amplified, but like a boxer, I buffet my body, handle it roughly, discipline it by hardships and subdue, for fear that after proclaiming to others the gospel and things pertaining to it, I myself should become unfit, not stand the test, and be unapproved and rejected as a counterfeit. Amen. Because now we talk about end times. The Bible says, in the last days, you're going to say, Lord, Lord, didn't I cast out devils? Didn't I lay hands on the sick? You know, that's not just a preacher. Mark 16 said we all can lay hands on the sick and they recover. So that's not just the preachers, the pulpit folk. I mean, the pew folk. Amen. Have as great a responsibility as those that are in the pulpit. So we have to continually examine ourselves. We have to examine our motives. We have to examine our heart. And then we have to look at the undercurrent. Say the undercurrent. Amen. In the ocean, the top water can look calm. Come on, the top water can look calm. And they'll say, you know what, don't go, what is that, on the board, surfing. Don't go surfing because of the undertow or the undercurrent, because it'll snatch you under and drown you. Amen. In our emotions, even though it looks like surfacely,
that we are healed and we are delivered. The Holy Spirit says, Shireen, there's an undercurrent. In folk, there's an undercurrent, amen, that when they say one thing inside their spirit, they are saying something else. That's called an undercurrent. You saying something with your mouth, but to yourself, you saying something else. You ever talk to people like that? Okay, that's called an undercurrent. That means your emotions with that person is not true. That is that you just told a lie. You just told a lie. You saying one thing, but in your mind you already changed it. That's an undercurrent in your emotions, and that's what'll take you out. Amen. So we must be responsible for making sure our spirit man is growing in the things of God, that our faith is continuously stirred and our prayer life doesn't go cold or lifeless. And while we are not subject to condemnation, we are subject to the word of God. Amen. So we are not exempt. Amen. So Paul says in 2 Corinthians 13 and 5, examine and test and evaluate your own selves to see whether you are holding to your faith and showing the proper fruits of it. Test, prove yourselves, not Christ. Do you not yourselves realize and know thoroughly by an ever-increasing experience that Jesus Christ is in you? Unless you are counterfeits, disapproved, on trial, and rejected. You won't know. You won't know. Amen. So the discussion that we're getting ready to go into is just going to really take us a couple of weeks. And we're going to talk about curses tonight. As well. And so curses are, and to acquire knowledge of them so that we'll be able to discern the activities of a curse. See, we talk about spirits and the strong man, but the strong man's identity might be in a curse. So you bind in the strong man, and they only are doing activities, but the curse is what's keeping him motivated. So this subject, you know, like I said, it's going to take us a minute. So the definition of curse, and there's so many people that agree, and the one that I really like is Derek Prince works on curses. Amen. And Apostle John Eckhart has written, and it's another couple of books I got, encyclopedia, one Bible encyclopedia that I have. And we know that the first curse came through the mouth of God. Amen. And so then it has been said that a curse is the penalty to be paid for breaking of a law. And the meaning is regarding God's law, the consequence that will occur because of disobedience and rebellion against God. In his book on breaking curses, he revealed that a curse is God's recompense in the life of a person and his or her descendants as a result of iniquity. It causes sorrow and it gives demonic spirits legal entrance into a family so that they can carry out and perpetuate their wicked devices. A curse is being empowered to fail. being cursed, as a blessing as it being empowered to succeed. So Derek Prince, in his definition, says curses are words spoken with some form of spiritual authority, either good or evil, that set in motion something that will go on generation after generation behind the words of a spiritual power. Amen. Amen. So curses, I list some of the curses that the Word of God speaks of in the Old Testament and the New Testament. And however, we know that Galatians 3:13 in the Amplified say Christ purchased our freedom, redeeming us from the curse, the doom of the law's condemnation, by himself becoming a curse for us. For it is written in the scriptures, cursed is everyone who hangs on the tree, is crucified. Amen. So we understand that we can be free. Amen. But we also understand that we must go take our freedom by telling the devil that, guess what, the blood is coming at you. That we are free. We are covered in the blood. We got to repeat the scripture. Come on, amen. How did Jesus defeat the devil? He had already defeated the devil. Amen, in Matthew 4. But when he came, he told the devil, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. So we have to tell the word to the devil so that he know that our hedge is protected. Is this good? Amen. So they have access into human personalities. And in researching, it said one of the seven things that Derek Prince identified were seven venues that the enemy hide within a person, causing all kinds of problems and oppressions, chronic financial problems, sickness, disease, female problems, inability to have children. Amen. Accident prone, marital problems, premature deaths, mental illness. Amen. Also identified was a family background in the occult or false religions. Negative prenatal influences. Pressures in early childhood. Emotional shock or sustained emotional pressure. Our own sinful acts and habits. People transferring spirits, laying hands on you, and you don't know them. Amen. And then the very words that come out of your mouth, the idle words that come out of your mouth. Amen. Say your family background in the occult, the consequence of the judgment can extend four generations. So two parents, four grandparents, eight great-grandparents, 16 great-great-grandparents. I don't care if you don't know them, they really exist. Amen. So a total of 30 persons, of which any one of them can or could be a channel through whom we may have been exposed to satanic influence. You have to identify the activity. Like you might say, you know, Uncle Bud died of a heart attack, and his daddy died, and on my mama's side. So we start identifying the activities of generational curses. We just don't know it's generational curses. You see what I'm saying? Amen. None of the women in that family get married. They mama didn't get married. Amen. So none of the women in that family, they just can't keep no man. So we it's generational curses. Amen. So the words that come from my lips, but I say to you that every idle, careless word that a man speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. Verse 37 says, for by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be what? Condemned. Amen. Because we know that the power of life and death is in the tongue. Amen. So how do our words get us? We can do self-imposed vows. I vow this never gonna happen to me. I vow this. So we make these vows like a Jephthah vow. God, if you do this, I'm gonna do that. Amen. Then we have witchcraft, things we say out of our mouth to pervert the scripture, to make the scripture come to pass out of impure motive, and then through the spirit of legalism. Amen. And so what it produces is barrenness in the realm of the spirit. Then we have those theologians. They exalt theology over revelation. Amen. Even in our conversations about the word, we'll try to be so doctrinally right, but you ain't got really revelation on how to live. You don't even have revelation on how to come to church. But you're trying to speak and teach the word of God as a spirit that you are subject to, and whomever you become pastor over, they subject to you. We see these talk shows. Those are pastors. People go for advice. They go for encouragement. They go for their knowledge. And their word is the gospel. If you tell me to read this, I'm going to read this. If you say it's good, I'm going to read this. I'm going to do this. So we go over psychology above discernment, reasoning above the walk of faith, laws above love. Amen. Then we have familiar spirits. We're going to probably get into those a little bit later. But this is the confessions that we might innocently do day to day. I seem to take one step forward and two steps back. Nothing ever seems to work out. I just can't get ahead. You cursing yourself. You're never going to get ahead because you can't see ahead of you. If it were not for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all. This always happens to me. It happened to my parents. Now it's happening to me. We talk about my cancer, my blood, my high blood, my low blood, my heart problem. We take ownership of diseases that are illegally lodged in our body. We got a criminal in us who has freedom to grow because we are in partnership by our mouths. So he is not subject to us. Our bodies are subject to it. Because we have ownership. He belongs here. My this, my that, my headache, my blood pressure was. They got me on my blood pressure pills. And, you know, we just take ownership like it's candy. No, I'm taking this, but God gonna heal me. I'm taking this and I'm expecting this body to line up so that this can be out of me. Amen. And you must decree over your life when you're taking that medicine. God, I thank you that this medicine is doing what it's supposed to do. I'm not going to be on this medicine forever. I'm going to be a walking epistle. I'm going to be read of all men. I'm going to be healed. I'm going to be delivered. I'm going to be used to perform miracles. Come on, somebody. You got to begin to decree life in you. And not only that, usefulness. Let the kingdom of God know that he needs you. It needs your testimony. Somebody need to believe God through you that God is a healer. Amen. Reverse this stuff. I can't speak in front of people expecting future failures. My children always left out. I'm always going to be poor. I can't start the day without my first cup of coffee. Just fill that body up with that caffeine. Wonder why you got chronic headaches. Ain't gonna be able to hardly make it through the fast. Amen. Because you've already made your body in need of that first cup of coffee. You have already purposed in your body that you can't. I'm gonna get decaf. I'm not gonna drink it like I was drinking. I'm gonna ease out of it. I'm gonna ease out of it. Amen. Amen. Then we talk about the sexual ties that bind one to another person who is not in a God-ordained marital relationship, and also bind a person psychologically. Amen. But while we're committing these acts, we don't understand the perverseness of them are affecting our seed. Woo! Causing confusion in your seed over their sexuality. Because whatever your sexual weakness is, or your weakness, whether it's sexuality, whatever your weakness, you might it will be perverted. He ain't gonna do the same thing. He gonna make their sin worse. Do you see why we need knowledge so that we can stand in the gap, so that we can keep our children virgins, so that we can keep them whole, so that when they get married, they're not fragmented like some of us was? How many people know some of us was messed up when we got married? Amen, amen, amen. So we married two messes. And sometimes they make it and sometimes they don't. Amen. So perversion that brings curses upon the children are in the forms of Apostle Eckhart, in his book on identifying and breaking curses, identifies these: sexual perversion that includes adultery, fornication, incest, bestiality, homosexuality, lesbianism, oral sex, and sex orgies, molestation, and rape. A history of these sexual sins in the bloodline opens doors for the curses of lust. Financial perversion includes the misuse of money, unjust gain, cheating, gambling, covetousness, not honoring God by tithing, bribes, crooked means of obtaining money, illegal trafficking of drugs and alcohol, and robbery and embezzlement. A history of sins in the bloodline can open the door for curses of poverty. Religious perversion includes idolatry, worshiping idols, ancestral worship, and oaths and pledges to idol gods. A history of these sins in the bloodline can open the door for the curse of idolatry and multiple curses. Spiritual perversion includes witchcraft, voodoo, sorcery, divination, occult involvement, and spiritualism. And a history of these sins in the bloodline can open the door for multiple curses. Behavioral perversion includes perverse way, pride, rebellion, drunkenness, murder, returning evil for good, sinful attitudes and ways, ungodly conduct, mistreating others, abuse, and unrighteous behavior. And then the familial perversion includes perversion of the family order, Ahab and Jezebel spirit, men not taking leadership, dominating females, rebellious children, or any time of God's order in the family is violated and neglected. This perversion opens the door upon marriages and family. Then perverse speech includes spoken curses, vexes, hexes, spells, lying, blasphemy, slander, crooked speech, vows, oaths, and pledges to idols, cults, false gods, enchantments, and bewitchments. Amen. So iniquity is the cause of the curse. Amen. So what we do, we have to pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I submit myself to you. This is personal. You got to know what you're dealing with. How many people dealing with some stuff? How many people can see that there's some stuff that came through the lines? Amen. And that you are going to be the one that's going to stop it, get it off your children, get off your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren. Come on. You can break. You got power through knowledge. You got power to take authority and dominion over the spirits that are harassing your family. Amen. So you can pray. You can renounce these things. Renounce these activities. Amen. Sever the soul tie. We're going to talk about soul tie, I believe, next week. Amen. Sever the soul ties that linked up through generations. Sever and bring back your innocence. Take your children's innocence back. Amen. So you have to renounce, cancel all the assignments of the enemies that are attempting to keep your family line in an ungodly soul tie setting. Amen. So it's watching the activities, being able to discern, you know, something's not right. Amen. If you're teaching one thing, everybody going another way. Come on, somebody. Amen. What interfered with the process? You got to identify what interfered with the process. Amen. Our children. Amen. And if we're married and then we remarried, then the kids coming into another group of parents and another type of parenting. Come on, doors are open. And there's a breakdown in the health of their emotions. Because they're torn between two loves. Am I helping anybody? Amen. So these are the things that bring answers so that we can win our generation back. We got to win our generation back. We got to give them life. Y'all hearing what I'm saying? We got to win this generation so they don't want to not be parents. And, you know, they won't go the other way. Having babies and don't care. Amen. They'll keep the family value that you have put in place. And it's time for us to stand up and take the rightful place and authority in the realm of the spirit. You cannot fight flesh and blood. You are fighting rulers, powers. Amen. Wickedness in high places, who have kept the doors of generations' weakness open over our lives, and especially in our community. So somebody got to believe the report of the Lord. Someone has to stand in the gap. Someone has to take authority, and someone has to get a turnaround. There's no reason why we don't have doctors and lawyers and professors and come on, amen, and geniuses. But the learning process is slowed down because what has interfered in their lives coming up. You can't concentrate and you going through it. What make you think your kids can't keep an A student with listening to you, looking at you? I want all A's. I want A's up in here, up in here. Come on, somebody. We have to look at ourselves. We have to look at what doors that we connected to through our ignorance. Amen. Sitting up in church. Amen. And dealing with so many frustrations because we don't know how to take authority over. We don't know how to take authority over our sexuality. Over our habits, over the sins of the father. The Bible said, Malachi, the sins of the father shall visit the children. So that's let us know. But Jesus became a curse. But if we never remind the devil that it stops here, I'm going to be healed. I am healed. I am delivered. I'm walking in the authority of my priesthood. I'm walking in the authority of the word of God. And you're going to turn loose my children. Anybody, come on, give God a praise offering. Come on, come on. Amen. Come on, God is going to do it. I know he is. I know he is. Amen. Father, we give you praise and we give you glory. And we bind every spirit of backlash. We thank you for the blood that covers every person, every family under the sound of my voice. We bless you now, God. And we bind every spirit of witchcraft. We bind every spirit, every hex, every spirit, every doctrine, every weapon, every arrow in the name of Jesus is reversed in Jesus' name. We take authority, Lord God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God. We renounce our ignorance. We renounce unbelief. We renounce every hidden sin. We renounce, Lord God, everything that we have held on from our childhood that has brought detriment to our families, to our mindsets, to our emotions. In the name of Jesus, we renounce, Lord God, the sin of unforgiveness. And we bless you now as we forgive our mother, our father, as we forgive those, Lord God, that came against us, as we forgive, Lord God, hallelujah, those that use us, as we forgive, Lord God, hallelujah, as we love and not hate. Lord God, we thank you now, Lord, hallelujah, for covering our minds and covering our hearts, Lord God, covering our spirits with your blood in the mighty name of Jesus. And God, we give you the glory and we give you the praise, Lord. We decree and declare, Father, we shall walk in our destiny. We shall walk in the plan that you have for us. Our children shall walk in their destiny and the plan that you have for their lives. And we bind every block. We bind everything that has tried to corrupt. We bind the spirit of perversion in the name of Jesus. And we give you the glory and we give you the praise, Lord God, as you make every crooked place straight, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. And oh God, that you would even deal with our seed, God. Lord God, we thank you for a spirit of forgiveness to be in our seed in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord God, those that have been taken captive, captive by the world, captive by the prisons, captive in their own mind, God, we bind the spirit of captivity over their lives in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord God, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty to the pulling down of strongholds. We pull down every stronghold, every attack of the enemy, every soul tie that have tried to bring itself against them. Lord God, we thank you, and we come against every disease that would try to interrupt their future in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you praise now in Jesus' name. Come on, give him praise. Come on, give him some praise. Come on, give him some glory. Come on, give him some praise. Whew. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You won't have us to be ignorant. Thank you, Lord. You said in all thy getting, get understanding. Thank you, Lord God, for teaching us how to fight. Thank you, Lord, for equipping this body in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, God, we give you praise. You say don't be weary in well-doing. God, we thank you. A faithful man shall abound in many blessings. Oh, God, we give you the glory. For it. We give you the glory, Lord. Thank you for your anointing. Let your anointing arise in the people. Let it arise, Lord, on their job. Let it arise, Lord God, on their way to work. Let it arise, Lord God, hallelujah, as you make us more than conquerors through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Come on, give God another praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, higher, bush, honey, oh, higher. Glory, glory, glory. Come on, give him some glory. Come on, give him some glory. Come on, break up the fallow ground. Break it up in the name of Jesus. No weapon formed against you. No weapon formed against your children. No weapon formed against your spouse. No weapon in the name of Jesus. It cannot, it shall not prosper. Come on and bless him. Come on, you're healed. You're delivered. Woo! Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He told the woman with the issue of blood, he said, woman, thy sins have been forgiven. My. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for wholeness today. Woo! Every vacancy, fill it up, God. Every vacancy in the emotion field of God. every vacancy in the heart, God. Every hurt, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, mama bobo shandidiahaya. In the dia bostikiaha. In the name of Jesus. Fill it shandidiahaya. In the name of Jesus. Fill it up, Lord God. Fill it with your life. Fill it with life. The Zoe life. Fill it, Lord God. In Jesus' name. Come on, give him some praise. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Amen. We're going to prepare for our church tithe and all.